Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Tech Warrior Channel. Today, many countries discuss the Saab JAS-39 Gripen fighter jet. The Saab JAS-39 Gripen is a light single-engine Multirole fighter aircraft manufactured by the Swedish aerospace and defense company Saab AB. The Gripen has a delta wing and canard configuration with relaxed stability design and fly-by-wire flight controls. Later aircraft are fully NATO interoperable. As of 2020, more than 271 Gripens of all models, AAF, have been built. The preferred aircraft was a single-engine, lightweight single-seater, embracing fly-by-wire technology, canards, and an aerodynamically unstable design. The powerplant selected was the Volvo Fliegmotor RM12, a license-built derivative of the General Electric F400 and 4400 engine development priorities were weight reduction and lowering component count. With approval from the Riksdag, the FMV issued contracts worth SEK 25.7 billion to Saab, covering 5 prototypes and an initial batch of production aircraft. Vision was converted to a flying test aircraft for the JAS-39's intended avionics, such as the fly-by-wire controls. The JAS-39 received the name Gripen via a public competition, which is the heraldry on Saab's logo. Saab rolled out the first Gripen on 26 April 1987, marking the company's 50th anniversary. Originally planned to fly in 1987, the first flight was delayed by 18 months due to issues with the flight control system. On 9 December 1988, the first prototype serial number 39-1 took its 51-minute maiden flight with pilot Stig Holmström at the controls. During the test program, concerns surfaced about the aircraft's avionics, specifically the fly-by-wire flight control system and the relaxed stability design. The Gripen is a Multirole fighter aircraft, intended as a lightweight and agile aerial platform with advanced, highly adaptable avionics. It has canard control surfaces that contribute a positive lift force at all speeds, while the generous lift from the delta wing compensates for the rear stabilizer, producing negative lift at high speeds, increasing induced drag. The Gripen also has good short takeoff performance, being able to maintain a high sink rate and strengthen to withstand the stresses of short landings. A pair of air brakes are located on the sides of the rear fuselage. The canards also angle downward to act as air brakes and decrease landing distance. It is capable of flying at a 70 to 80 degrees angle of attack. To enable the Gripen to have a long service life, roughly 50 years, Saab designed it to have low maintenance requirements. Major systems such as the RM12 engine and PS05/A radar are modular to reduce operating cost and increase reliability. The Gripen was designed to be flexible, so that newly developed sensors, computers, and armaments could be integrated as technology advances. The aircraft was estimated to be roughly 67% sourced from Swedish or European suppliers and 33% from the US. The Gripen is compatible with a number of different armaments. Beyond the aircraft's single 27mm Mauser B-27 cannon omitted on the 2C variants, including air-to-air missiles such as the AIM-9 Sidewinder, air-to-ground missiles such as the AGM-65 Maverick, and anti-ship missiles such as the RBS-15. In 2010, the Swedish Air Force's Gripen fleet completed the MS-19 upgrade process, enabling compatibility with a range of weapons, including the long-range MBDA Meteor missile, the short-range IRIS-T missile, and the GBU-49 laser-guided bomb. Speaking on the Gripen selection of armaments, Saab's campaign director for India, Edvard de Lamotte, stated that if you buy Gripen, select where you want your weapons from. Israel, Sweden, Europe, US, South America. It's up to the customer.